Spurs manager Keith Birkinshaw makes a couple of changes. Paul Miller comes into the defence in place of Gordon Smith, his height to offset the challenge of Joe Jordan. Ricky Velia comes back to the number 11 shirt, and John Pratt moves down to substitute. Meanwhile, Manchester United manager Dave Sexton has named an unchanged side for the fifth successive game. A side that was last here 5 weeks ago when they beat Spurs 2-1 in a first division match. Indeed, the two clubs met in the FA Cup sixth round last season when United won on a replay. United, I'm sure, will know all about the scoring capabilities too of Glenn Hoddle. A brilliant goal against them here in the League Cup and another in the league game as well. The referee today is Pat Partridge from County Durham. And for the mighty crowd that's been queuing up White Hart Lane almost since dawn, the long wait at last is over. So it's Chris Jones passing to Terry Gibson as Spurs get the game away. They're in the white shirts, attacking the goal to our right. Manchester United in their famous red. United have lost only one of their last 8 games, and that was at Liverpool, so there's some excuse for that. Spurs, in fact, who've not won a home FA Cup tie since 1972 when they beat Rotherham in the fourth round, and that's certainly a record that they'll want to bury today. Miller playing it back to Alexic. There's about 9 inches in height difference there between McQueen and Gibson. A nice picture. Now trying to get Gibson on his way. Now McQueen. Well, the little man caused a mild amount of panic there, because I think McQueen for a moment lost his footing. But he's certainly quick. Terry Yorath having a long talk there, a long shout there with Terry Gibson, giving me the impression that maybe they want Gibson to have a run at the ball, through balls over the back four to test his speed and United's defence. Still doing it, as you can see. Terry Yorath, a good captain. Now it's Yorath playing it there towards Chris Jones. No penalty. The referee had a good look at it and kept his arms firmly behind him. Say that looked dangerously close to being a penalty to me, but instead it's Jordan sending McElroy on his way. A little back pass here for Macari to have his shot charged down by Perriman. And a throw. That certainly, that incident a moment ago, looked perilously close to being a penalty for Tottenham. And Houghton, well, he got it away, but only as far as Koppel. Played on this time for Wilkins, and a brilliant piece of keeping by Velia Alexic. All starting when Chris Houghton did well, in fact, to get down there, but his clearance was a poor one. Gave Manchester United possession, and Wilkins sprinting away there suddenly saw the opportunity. What a good save it was, though, by Alexic. Thomas with the corner for Manchester United. McQueen up on the line again, jostling there with Alexic. Corner floated in one, and a good one too. Oh, just got his fingertips to that, did Alexic, and it's Jordan now for Manchester United again, looking to get the better of Miller, but couldn't do so. And Ardiles is there to help on his way, but again a clearance, only coming as far as Wilkins once more. Curled in there towards Koppel. The flag stayed down, and Koppel couldn't quite get his foot to it. So Wilkins almost not scoring, because it was a good save by Alexic in one moment, and then popping up on the other side of the field, curling that one in, helped by the wind which was behind it, and Koppel just failing to get his foot to it. So two good pieces of play there by Ray Wilkins. McAllister.
Yorath. Ardiles. Knocked out of the way there by...
Oh, a tremendous save by Gary Bailey from Chris Jones. After McQueen had blocked that shot, which looked as though it might have been dangerous, and it looked as though United had got over that little crisis. A good shot taken quickly by Jones, and what a save. And a foul on the keeper as the corner's taken. And a free kick to Manchester United. But no doubt, so far as Manchester United are concerned, who the hero of this particular moment is, it's Gary Bailey.
Yorath playing it in now, again for Ardiles.
Little dummy there on McElroy.
Now for Jones.
Oh. Well, he's firing him in. That time, Bailey was leaping across his goal, but he didn't get a touch to it and didn't have to. Just a fraction too high.
Coppell busying himself down there. And Macari as well, but it's a goal kick.
Oh, a corner. Flicked off a Tottenham defender.
Queen up again. McElroy. Jordan, a big threat as well. Chris Jones back to watch Gordon McQueen. Again with a corner curled in there. Chris Jones getting up but didn't quite get a touch to it. Wilkins trying to get a touch to it. He didn't also. Macari there, and it's still not in.
And it was very nearly Wilkins who got the final touch. And now here's Thomas, onside, but a goal kick. Well, what an amazing scrimmage that was a moment ago in that Tottenham six-yard area. Macari had a shot, and Alexic beat it down superbly. And in the end, it looked as though it might come for Wilkins, but no, Spurs got it away. And the linesman is flagging on this side now, he may have seen it. Certainly what I saw was Nicol slapping at Gibson. Now the linesman is coming out onto the field to have a word with the referee here.
Players, look, I don't want any conversation with you. He's feeling in his pocket for a card for Jimmy Nicol. It's a yellow card. Well, I think that'll be greeted with a certain amount of relief by Manchester United fans who saw it. They may have thought that it might have been more severe. And what Jimmy Nicol might well be saying is that something had happened to him before he retaliated. Tell you, but I certainly saw a slap, and you've seen a yellow card against the railings. Well, that was what young Terry Gibson was doing a few years ago on the terraces. Now Hoddle, just over.
Hoddle has not had the best of first halves, and his passing has been just that little bit below par by his standards. He caught that sweetly enough.
And the half-time whistle goes. A goalless first 45 minutes.
And my word, it wouldn't have been if Chris Jones had had a little more luck with his shot, or indeed if Gary Bailey hadn't been in such superbly acrobatic form to claw it away when it looked odds-on. Spurs going into the lead. First half that really hasn't quite lived up to the great expectations that we had of the game, but very exciting in bursts, with Spurs having a couple of rifling shots on goal, and indeed Milia Aleksic being called upon to make two saves, one from Wilkins and one from Macari, that might easily have put United into a lead. A very evenly balanced third-round FA Cup tie here at White Hart Lane. A half-time score, Spurs 0, Manchester United 0, and we'll be back with the second half.
So Manchester United get us away at the start of the second half as we welcome you back to White Hart Lane. The score 0-0. Manchester United now attacking the goal to our right. Pitch really in remarkably good condition after such terrible weather in the London area this week. In fact, Spurs used or borrowed the covers from Lords to cover one of the penalty areas that was particularly hard hit by frost. It's the Gary Bailey penalty area at the moment, but it was a penalty area that was shielded by that stand for so much of the time, but the cricket covers did the trick. Well, Jordan's okay again. A free kick for Manchester United, who've attacked well in the first half. And back it goes to Milia Aleksić. McAllister to Hoddle. Another throw to Spurs. And a four for Ardiles. Got Gibson up as well, but well, he got it at the second go, and here's Hoddle. The little chip coming in towards Villa, but Jimmy Nicholls there, and Koppel then gets it away. Free kick. Bukhari and Miller getting a little too heartily involved there. Maybe not as light-hearted as I at first thought. And Bukhari just being called across for a quick word, and Miller as well. Well, as long as the warning is observed. Now towards Gibson, who popped up there with a header. Chris Jones there. Gibson trying to get in once more. Ardiles with a chance! Houston with the throw for Manchester United. Yorath with the header away. Bucket now for United. Jordan's throw. Got it on there towards McQueen by Jordan. Comes out for Copley. Blasted that well. Hughton got in the way of it, though. Wilkins now trying to go all the way. No, a little pass here for Jimmy Nicol. Crossed in once more. A deep one towards McQueen, who was pushed. And a penalty, I think, has been given. Yes. The push on Gordon McQueen has planted the ball on the penalty spot. There's the push, and it looked a good one. It looked a good penalty. And now it's a question as to whether McIlroy... Well, I think the yellow card's coming out first for too many Spurs protests. And it might be Ardiles, the hero of a moment ago, indeed it is, Ardiles, who gets the yellow card for protesting too vehemently about that penalty. Well, I wonder how many people would care to be in Sammy McIlroy's shoes at this moment, or indeed in the shoes or boots of Melia Alexic. So, here we go then. Oh, a further delay, the ball not properly on the spot. Winding up the temperature a little bit more. McIlroy now. 1-1! Sammy McIlroy, his fourth goal of the season and his second penalty, hit really firmly to Alexic's right. Spurs 1, Manchester United 1. Sammy McIlroy, his nerve held in spite of the delays. Here's Ardiles again. Thomas after him this time, and again the little Argentine goes over the outstretched foot of Thomas, although Thomas had taken the ball. Question of a foul. Nicol with a throw for Manchester United. Ferryman acrobatically away. Nicely controlled by Ardiles, and away he goes again with Gibson away on the right. Here on the left is Jones. Villa's gone up to join the attack as well. Holland's away on the far side. Gibson just getting in there, but Bailey just a fraction of a second before him. But again, the 17-year-old showed his speed. And in fact, hung his foot out there just a little too long, his experience maybe. And that could have been very painful indeed for Bailey. A free kick for Manchester United. Koppel. Played on beautifully there by Koppel for McIlroy. Jordan's through the middle. Koppel's gone through there quickly as well. Macari's up and Thomas. But Spurs crowded them out. Nicol playing it in early. And a free kick. Well, I didn't hear the whistle from that. I wonder what Yorath was doing. But he knew all right, and he's found Huddle. And now it's with Gibson. But running into McQueen brought him no profit. Villa with the shot just over. It's almost the first time we've seen little Terry Gibson running with the ball. But McQueen crowded him out. Ophelia shot. Well, that wasn't too far over. As we come to the last 12 minutes or so of the game, Spurs will be putting everything, you can be sure, so far as attack's concerned, into those last 12 minutes. They can hardly relish another visit to Old Trafford. Ardiles. Into a box again, down he goes. My word, that looked to me. Well, the United players are standing over Ardiles rather accusingly, saying that you are tending to dive a little bit. That again seemed to be a bit close penalty wise. Yoris had a touch on by Jones. Gibson's after that one. That certainly looked again like obstruction, which it was, 17-year-old. Cordelius taking it quickly. Yorath turning it in. And it was Stuart Houston, in fact, who was more quick-witted maybe than anybody in that Manchester United defence at that particular moment. Spotted the danger, got it away. It's a corner. Gibson's taken a bang on the head. Hoddle with that corner. Jones trying to go in there, somehow kept it in play. And Mukkari getting there before Yorath. But now Yorath turning it wide, and how well he did it. Onside. Now Hoddle. No, my word, how did that stay out? That was absolutely amazing. Hoddle played onside. We'll have a look, see what happens here first as Wilkins turns it inside, this time for McIlroy. And that time Yorath was there to get it away. Now a free kick to Manchester United, but how near they came to conceding a second goal as Hoddle went roaring in there. And it was Mickey Thomas, in fact, who finished up in the back of the net, who somehow kept the ball out of that goal. An amazing situation. Our deal is to Hoddle. He's had a much better second half. That might come for Villa. And, well, Bailey scooped that one up. That was a really fierce ground shot hit there by the Argentine. First time. Yorath could get there. It comes for Thomas, though. Terrific game he's had. Wilkins played a good ball there for Koppel. Hit well across the face of the goal, though. Behind for the goalkeeper. Shot! Wow! A foot wide, maybe no more. Little Argentine dancing there when that ball went just past the post. He thought for a moment it was going just inside, but made so much good space for himself to get his shot in. Ardiles. Oh, he did well to beat Houston there. And Turman Summer had it saved at very point blank range by Gary Bailey. The first go at a shot was Gibson's, and then it came to Perriman, and Bailey was right on him. Looks as though they're going to make a substitution. In fact, in the last seconds of the game, Chris Jones is hobbling off, and John Pratt, who in fact scored here last week against Stoke City, the Spurs winner, comes on. My word, he's got so little time to repeat that dose now. The throw coming to Manchester United, and it's problematical whether he can even get a touch of the ball. Well, I'm not quite sure what Terry Gibson was doing there, blasting that ball away. That's going to waste a few more seconds. If Spurs are leading 1-0, that might have been a little more understandable. Chris Jones hobbling away. Corner. Nearly 2 minutes of injury time played. Mickey Thomas with the corner for Manchester United. McQueen up again. Will they snatch it right at the very end? They weren't, because there wasn't even time to take the corner. John Pratt, who came on as substitute, didn't even get a touch of the ball, and they have to play again at Old Trafford on Wednesday, after Osvaldo Ardiles had put Tottenham ahead early in the second half. And then when there was a push on Gordon McQueen, Pat Partridge had no doubts that it was a penalty, and the nerve of Sammy McIlroy held for him to plant it high and wide to the right of Milia Aleksic to make it 1-1. Spurs having much the better of the second half, and no question in my mind in the end, the last analysis, who the hero for United was. Gary Bailey, the goalkeeper, one tremendous save from Chris Jones in the first half, and then an equally brilliant one from close range from Steve Perriman a minute from time. So as the players troop off, a final scoreline here at White Hart Lane in this third round FA Cup tie. Spurs 1, Manchester United 1.